Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And I need to continue with the story of last week of how I came to Germany. So this is part two of the vlog. At that time it became really, really difficult because he had to go back home. And again, he will need to book another appointment. My aunt was really, really sad that my uncle was turned back and told he should come with her to the Rathaus. Yeah, to cut the story short. So now we have arrived in September. So in September, the earliest appointment was the almost 1 week before my aunt goes. And there was a lot of pressure building up in my side because the universities had opened. And it was orientation time. She was given the appointment exactly 1 week before she comes to Kenya. So she was told that she needs to go to the office in the morning and sign. By that time, her colleague was not at work and she had to replace him. And she was very busy in the morning because running a hotel is not easy. She told me, no, the way they have set it this time, I don't like it. I'm going to go at my lunch hour. I knew deep inside that she's not going to sign the Verpflichtung Declarung because you cannot tell a government for you to come at your own appointed time to sign in some details or to conduct some transaction. After lunch hour, she called me, oh shit, they have locked, I cannot sign. Then I need to book another appointment. And the appointments are available is when she is already in Kenya. So there was no way she was gonna do that. And she tried contacting the Rathaus. The Rathaus told her, we gave you this time and you did not show yourself. We don't have available time. Just heartbroken because this was just the final stage. I kept on pressurizing her and telling her whether she could postpone her travel and make sure she signs for me the Verpflichtung Declarung. She had said no. I remember me asking her, did you really want me to come to Germany? She was like, I really wanted you to come. Had I not want you to come, I would not be this deep in this process. I started questioning her and trying to push my way to come to Germany. And I remember she just called me and told me, Chris and I have decided we are not signing the Verpflichtung Declarung. It was nerve-wracking. I really cried. Remember a time that I almost committed suicide because of that. Those words, it really hurt me because remember, this is my aunt. I trusted her with my life. With my life. And even talking about it, I end up very emotional about it. It's so emotional that she would do that to me. And up to today, I really don't know. I have not gotten closure of everything. I have not spoken to her. When I came to Germany, I didn't even speak to her. I have never met her. I still have unanswered questions. Why did she do this? Why did she say those hurtful things to me? Yet I have always been there for her. I trusted her with my life. I was so deep in this process of coming to Germany. I became so desperate. This desperation made me send messages to prominent people like Raila, Sonko, all these prominent people that I know, explaining my situation. The reason as to why I really pursued this Germany thing was that I used to feel really disrespected whenever I was in Kitale because I had just graduated.
And I was in Kitale, and I didn't have a job, graduating from my international university. People disrespecting me because maybe they're saying, ah, who are you? This person has no prospects in life. I felt disrespected by my own family, and it really got the best out of me, to be honest. I reached a point where I was very, very silent and numb, and I really and filled with so much pain inside of me. It really hurt me though. It really does. Up to now, my aunt came to Kenya, and I did not see her. I went to visit my other cousin, and I explained to her about my problem. This was in mid or early September. So my friend was like, I see parents borrow loans for their children, and I'm sure your mom cannot afford you to lose this opportunity, because you're only left with the visa process, which is not very long. This is just a one-time thing. I'm sure your mom can borrow a loan, and she can sponsor you in that aspect of ticking the blocked account and depositing 10,000 euros into your blocked account. It took a lot of days and a lot of hours trying to convince my mom to do such a thing. Mind you, we were never very close. We had drifted apart. And for her to do that, I would say that was the most generous thing she has ever done in my life. She deposited 10,000. It came with a lot of conditions, that you will need to pay this amount of money. I'm borrowing it for you, so you need to pay it back. After depositing it, I booked an appointment with the embassy. I went to the embassy, presented all my details, all my credentials, and I had to wait for 30 days. So that extended until October, I think mid-October. And during this period, I was back in Kitale. Mid of October, I finally got my passport. Once I got a hold of my parcel, which contained my visa, I mean my passport, I was very terrified to open it. I had to close my eyes, then I gently tore the upper part and put my fingers inside the envelope and take my passport. So when I felt the paper, I was like, oh my God, visa denied. And then I counted the paper was just two, and then I just pulled out my passport and I said, you know what, I don't care even if I'm being denied or accepted. At this point, I have to brace myself for the worst, and I have to brace myself for the probably the better life that I will get when I open my eyes. So I put the parcel paper on the other side. I took my passport, and where the paper was placed in a certain page. So, and I opened my eyes and I saw the paper, and then about visa regulations, and then they're telling me, welcome to Germany. And I was like, what the fuck? I opened my passport, and you can imagine, here it is. As you can see, my passport, that's what it read. I was shocked. I was literally shocked.
I didn't know what to say. That's how my journey to Germany began. And I didn't waste time. I immediately booked my flight for the next weekend. Key lessons that I have learned and has stood strong in my life after arriving in Germany is that learn to trust your instincts and learn to believe in yourself. It's only you who can make mountains move for yourself. No one else can. Number two, don't trust too much, because when you trust too much, you'll be disappointed as much. Number three, just love yourself and be happy that you have known and passed through all these other events in order to lead you to somewhere greater. Number five, be confident and never lose hope. I want to let you know that if I could make it to Germany, also you can make it. I wish you all a fantastic day ahead, and always know that you are loved, you are cared about, and stick to your dreams. If I could make it, so could you. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, comment. I would be looking forward to hearing from you. Cheers. Bye.